Coming up next on Good Looks, we'll discuss the care and art of nails. When we talk about the do's and don'ts of cosmetics, we'll get you to not only look good, but feel good too. I'm your host, Dee Gay.
And I'm Mike Zuba. We are talking about nails, caring for them, and exploring the combination of nails and artwork. But first, we want to remind everyone at home that this is a call-in show, so if you have any questions on today's topic, give us a call at 1-800-901-9238. Now, before we start, let's head over to Gainesville to see an artist at work.
Hi, I'm Shell Alexis, and I'm an artist. Today we are doing coffin-shaped nails. So the first step is to take care of the nail, the natural nail that's already here. We're gonna treat the cuticles and prepare the nails for our tips. We're just gonna put it into a cotton ball and just kind of clean up the nails. Take all the natural oils out. Now we're gonna very, very gently push her cuticles back. Now we're gonna take our file and we're gonna just gently go over the nails. We wanna create a rough surface so that when we glue our tips on, they'll hold firm. So we're gonna put just a glob of glue within each tip. You just want to put just a little blob of glue on the tip. You don't want to put too much or it'll overflow everywhere. But then you want to just kind of press down on the nail so that the glue will hold. Hold it for a few seconds. Should be good. Now that we have them all glued on, we're going to cut them down to the length that she prefers. So the first thing we're gonna do is pour some of our acrylic liquid into our little mixing bowl. Do that. Since we're doing a coffin shape, we're just gonna kind of bring the sides in with the file. Now that her nails are filed into the shape as desired and buffed, we're gonna have her wash her hands. Oh, since we're using acrylic paints, we're not gonna use a top coat of fingernail polish because we want this rough surface to paint on. So we're gonna paint directly onto this rough surface before we even go in with our top coat. So for the first finger, we're just gonna paint like a little sunflower here, coming off the side of the finger. We're gonna start off with yellow and do just the indications of where our petals are gonna be. And after we have that, we can go in with a little bit of orange, teeny tiny little bit of orange, and kind of do some indications of the center of the, and this is the theme that we're going for this set. Now we're just gonna kind of repeat the process.
Wow, you can do so much with nails. Today we have with us nail technician Ashton Terry and her model Antiana Reeves to show us some of the tricks of the trade. Welcome, ladies, so let's get started. Ashton, what are you going to be showing us today?
Today I'll be demonstrating the waterless marble nail technique. I already completed her left hand, so I'll be working on her right hand throughout the show. already completed a base coat on these two nails, which I'll be doing the marble nail technique on. So first, the first step you do is to choose your colors that you want to use for your marble nail technique. And we decided to do a black, a white, and a gray color.
Can the viewers at home obtain these readily at, say, a big box store or one of the local beauty supply houses?
Yes, I would say that viewers can. They can also use just regular nail polish at home. You can use the regular nail polish brush to accomplish the marble nail technique. And if they want a more detailed brush, they can go to a local retailer such as Sally Beauty Supply to purchase nail art brushes.
Ashton, what are you thinking are like the trends right now with nails? Like, tell us like what's really popular right now, what's trending?
Right now, I noticed that online cow print nails are really trending right now. Also, tie-dye nails are very popular as well.
Is it still popular to have like what you're doing now, like the ring finger and another finger, like different from the rest of the nails? And
I would say that accent nails are still very, very popular. Sometimes clients just want a certain pop, a certain zest on their nails. And I think that accent nails really help them accomplish that. They want to accent maybe on their ring finger or different jewelry that they're wearing.
So what are you doing now? Can you explain to our audience what's happening, how you're accomplishing?
Right now, I'm beginning to create the marble nail design. I went in with the white, and I just made just some random lines on her nails to create the marble effect.
Are you layering this product? Is that what you're doing, layering the colors to achieve what your final design?
I first start off as just a single layer. I sometimes will do maybe diagonal lines with the gray. I'll go in with that, and I may put white down the middle. Sometimes I'll do a horizontal line or a diagonal line. It's all, I do different techniques to create the varying degrees of the marble nails.
Oh, we have a caller, Celine from Sanford. Go ahead with your question, caller.
Play to keep natural nails healthy.
All right. Ashton, the caller wants to know, how do you keep your natural nails healthy?
I think the number one way to keep your natural nails healthy, if you wear nail polish, would be to wear a base coat. It helps protect your natural nail from yellowing when you wear nail polish. And if you don't wear nail polish, or if you do, you can also frequently get manicures. Make sure that you wear gloves when working outdoors or working with equipment or washing dishes. It's very important to keep your nails and your hands healthy in general that way.
That was a great question. Thank you, caller. Ashton, I know the old saying, they're jewels, not tools, correct, when you're talking about nails?
Yes, they are. They definitely are. And any damage to your nail can cause potential permanent damage to your, if you damage your nail matrix.
Now, are you working on Antiana? Are those her natural nails, or does she have acrylic or anything?
Right now, I'm working on Antiana's natural nails. She doesn't have much of a free edge.
Do you have to cap the free edge or anything when you're doing these, when you're painting her nails or doing this artwork?
Yes, it's very important to cap the free edge of a nail, because they ensure that you encapsulate the polish and that it will maintain the longevity of the nail design and style.
All right, we have another call. We have Oliver on the phone. Oliver, go ahead with your question.
Hi. My wife, Ursula, she's always getting her nails done and gets the little designs painted on. And short of wearing gloves all the time, is there a good way to protect the little drawings on her fingertips?
The best way would be to wear gloves or be careful about putting your hands in a lot of water. You know, it's It depends. If they're put on with gel, they will last a little bit longer than with just polish. So, but yeah, you still have to be very careful, especially with like rhinestones and things like that. I mean, because you want to protect them, like we said, they're jewels, not tools. So anytime you use your nails to like scrape something or cleaning something, you want to be careful. Putting your hands in harsh chemicals can cause, you know, the polish to change colors or some of those designs to fade a little bit. But thank you for your question. That was great. So let's talk about shapes of nails that are really popular right now. I know in the video they talked about coffin nails. And I know like stiletto nails are very popular right now. What are some other trends that you're seeing?
Currently, trends I'm seeing, I see kind of like a reemergence of people going back to the classic shapes such as almond nails and oval nails because they're timeless shapes and they tend to go great with your basic manicure, also designs as well.
How about the squoval, the square and the oval combined? Is that one still popular?
I haven't really seen much of the squoval. I haven't really seen too much of it, but I know it's a classic shape as well. Some people really enjoy the combination of the square and oval nail shape. And it works great with a French manicure as well. It gives a bit of a different look to it.
Ashley, there's so much nail art out there right now. Like, how would somebody decide, like, where would you go to decide on like a design? Like if you had no idea what you wanted, but you had a special occasion or something coming up, where are some good, like, I don't know, websites or something that you can look on to get some ideas?
If someone's looking for a nail design, I would recommend checking out Pinterest. I have so many different nail designs you can find on there, as well as Instagram. There's also YouTube. You can also look on Facebook, different social media sites.
So those are all go-tos for design, element, and artwork. Do you see a lot of clients, Ashton, that maybe want artwork on all their nails, or are we just concentrating it on a few? What's the trend? What's happening?
I noticed that the trend is doing simple designs on all of your nails. As far as the cow print nails goes, I see it often on all the nails. It's more popular compared to just on accent nails. And the same thing goes for tie-dye nails as well.
Are the stickers still really popular, like minks and those where you apply like a sticker over the nail with a gel coat?
The stickers are somewhat popular, but I think they have evolved into people using nail stamps. You can purchase nail stamps to just stamp on designs.
You know what? I just thought of something, Ashton, that our caller asked us about protecting his wife's nail, the designs. I just thought of this, but a gel top coat that you cure in the light would have probably been a great answer for that also. Would you think that would have protected the design a little better?
Oh, yes, definitely.
So it'll seal that design in, Dee? So
yes.
If she has her hands in water, and it depends what kind of work she does, right?
Yes.
For a living, actually.
Yes, because I know with the gel polish now, I mean, you can get up to 2 weeks lasting color and on the end designs on natural nails.
So what do you see as trending as far as colors too? What are clients asking for? Does it depend on their age group and so forth? Or do we have a lot out there that they rely on you as a true artist to guide them as far as what kind of art they like on their nails?
I think it all depends on the client, on their lifestyle. I noticed a shift from the classic French manicure to more just new nail polishes. The grays and the mauve colors, those are very popular.
How about the trend of the nails have to match the toenails? Is that still one of those fashion rules, or?
Some people still adhere to that fashion rule, but some people like to mix it up, maybe do a fun color on their toenails if they have to be more conservative at work with their nail polish.
Yeah, I've noticed people are braver on their feet, like with their toes. They'll go a little wild and then their hands are a little more conservative.
So now we're addressing the feet. Do people do artwork, have nail art on their feet? Do they do it on the nails?
I noticed that as far as nail designs go for on the feet, the big toe tends to be the most popular because it's the largest nail area to work with.
How about the gel polish on the toenails? That's very popular now, isn't it?
Oh, yes, definitely. It's great because you don't have to worry about your nail polish scraping off when you put on socks or sneakers, and it has a great longevity to it as well.
How about wedding designs? Like, what's really popular right now for brides with their nails?
Right now, what's popular for brides would be the nude nail polishes, and also some brides choose to do a pop of blue on their nails to incorporate something blue.
Prom season's upon us too, right, Dee? So
yes.
The young ladies will be having that done.
Oh, yes, definitely.
How about the Swarovski crystals? Do they still cover like one or two nails totally with those, or?
Yes, that's still very popular. In fact, sometimes scrolling through Instagram or Pinterest, I'll see some designs where all the nails are covered in that.
That makes a fashion statement, right?
Oh,
bling.
Yeah. My daughter likes it. She's bougie. She really does. So, she likes all of that, the wild colors, the nail art.
And that's not reserved for any age. It just depends how you put yourself out there, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, she does like it.
And also, I noticed that they have different nail charms you can add to your nails as well. As far as acrylic and gel nails go, if you have nail extensions, you can get like a tiny hole punched into them and mm-hmm. have a charm hanging from them.
And that was very popular in the 80s, and that's a trend we're seeing coming back, which is funny. You know, like we've said it before on the show, what is it?
Everything old is new again.
Right? That's right. Everything old is new again. So, and if you live long enough, you see them come back around. So, I hate to admit it, but it does.
Yeah, that's very true. I think that also the nail trends tend to copy what's popular with fashion and hair as well. They all kind of mold together what's popular.
Yeah, I remember when Adele sang, you know, her first big hit and her nails were pointed. I noticed everybody went to the stiletto and the pointy nails, and she really like set the trend for that and got it started again, which was an old trend from the 60s. Women did it to make their hands and their nails look thinner and smaller, you know, and more slim. So we do tend to follow the stars and, you know, what Hollywood's doing and what the fashion trend is. What happens on the runway trickles down, you know, to us.
Yes, that's definitely true. I remember reading an article recently that Kendall Jenner was featured with cow print nails, and after that, I started noticing more articles about cow print nails, and I started seeing on my Instagram feed with different cow print nail designs.
So nail art, does it go with the seasons too, like the holiday seasons? Do they change? Do you have, like, say, for Valentine's Day, and we just passed the holiday if you celebrate, you know, the Easter holiday and Halloween and so forth?
Yes, definitely. I would say that people like to express themselves through their nails with the different holidays that correspond. You'll see reds and greens and golds really popular for Christmas. With Easter, you may see more pastel colors. Halloween, of course, you'll see jack-o'-lanterns and things of that nature.
So are there a lot of tools that are needed when you're experimenting with nail art for our viewers at home if they want to try this at home and get really creative?
I would say that if viewers want to try this at home, they just simply need your standard brush that comes with nail polish. But also with me, I have some tools to show viewers what they could purchase if they would like. I have this detail brush that you can use for doing small details on the nails, such as maybe sunflower designs or adding different small intricate details.
Explain to our viewers the difference between acetone and non-acetones and which polish remover that they should use, depending on their nails.
The acetone nail polish is stronger, it's more abrasive on the nail. It's great for if you have glitter polish or dark polishes such as black or dark grays. And it's not recommended to use on artificial nail enhancements because it will actually degrade them. And non-acetone is great for when you have artificial nail enhancements.
How about cuticles? How the polish close to the cuticle? Does it tend to dry the cuticle out? And what would be the remedy that a client can possibly do to help this from happening? Or
I would recommend not polishing too close to the cuticle. But if you happen to get polish on the cuticle, you can simply take something such as this cleanup brush to clean up the cuticle area. And it's also important to take care of your cuticle area as well by removing your cuticle whenever you get manicures done, making sure that you don't have any of your cuticle on your nail plate, because it can affect the application of polish, and it can affect the longevity of your manicure.
So you were talking about natural nail care and having regular manicures. So if someone complains about their cuticles always peeling or dryness and stuff, regular manicures would help that?
Oh, yes, definitely. I would say if someone has problems with their cuticle area drying out, I would recommend using oil on your cuticle. They could also do a hot oil treatment on their nails to help with the dryness of their cuticle area.
So that would be like a Lactol manicure?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Well, did that help soften that cuticle and keep the cuticle moist around the nail?
It would help to soften the cuticle and keep it moist around the nail. And if you do it, every so often, it can help to soften up the cuticle and maintain it.
What advice do you have for nail biters?
For nail biters, they have different nail polishes that you can purchase that have a bad taste to them that help prevent you from biting your natural nail.
So you put like cayenne pepper, right? Don't bite those nails when you were young.
Right? I know that sometimes if people have problems with biting their nails, sometimes they'll get acrylic nails to prevent them from biting, because no one really wants to bite on acrylic nails.
Yeah, you can actually chip your tooth and cause even more problems.
That's a headache that no one wants.
Mm-hmm. So what do you have left to do on her nails, Ashton?
So right now I'm just doing the finishing touches on the marble nail design, and it's important to work on the marble nail design before the polish dries out, because once it dries out, it's no longer movable on the nail plate. And I'm also demonstrating this is the waterless marble nail design technique, but you can also complete it with water. If you take a small shallow bowl of water and just add drops of nail polish to it in, just a few colors, maybe two or three. You can even do five if you like. And then you would take a toothpick or a small brush and move it around in the pattern that you desire. And you would pick it up and apply it to the nail plate, form it, buff out the sides because there will be some excess. And you would just top it off with a top coat.
When you talk about the tie-dye, the dip nails, where they can dip it in the water with the different colors, how do you protect the skin around the nail from, gathering up that polish?
There are different things you can use. They have polish guards that you can use. You can use tape to protect your the size of your nail from collecting polish.
I saw where one nail artist used some Elmer's glue mixed in with a little bit of polish. Have you seen that? And then you can polish it around and it peels right off.
Oh, yes. They have different DIY techniques all over YouTube and all over the internet that you can try if you don't want to purchase polish guards, some different at-home products that people have laying around home.
Would that be finished with a clear coat now when you're done with the marbling, or what is the regime? What would happen next when you have a marble nail?
What would happen next, you would top it off with a clear top coat to encapsulate the design to make sure that it has longevity that the client desires.
Dee, you were saying about Elmer's glue. I got scared. I thought you were going to say duct tape. You know, the go-to for everything.
Hey, that'll keep the polish from adhering to the skin.
Yeah, it will.
Yeah, but the Elmer's glue trick is a fraction of the cost of that polish guard, so it really is a great tip for those that, you know, want to do them at home and love that tie, you know, dyed look.
Oh, yes, definitely. And I mean, it's like Dee says, a fraction of the cost, and you can purchase it anywhere, and you know, it's a multi-use item as well.
So are we finished with that marble look? Or?
Yes, we are finished with the marble look.
Wow, that looks really great.
Thank you so much.
It does. Well, thank you, ladies. That was very nice. Well, that's all the time that we have for today. If you were not able to get all your questions answered, then feel free to email us at wdsctv@daytonastate.edu. You can also find us on YouTube. Thank you for joining us on Good Looks.